Transitioned over into the marketing department as convention manager just in time for the launch of Fairy Tail, and got to do the premiere of Fairy Tail with our two guests here at New York Comic Con when the first collection came out. So without further ado, I would like to bring two very, very special gentlemen up to the stage that are a huge part of why Fairy Tail has been so unbelievably popular. I would like to first welcome Mr. Newton Pittman, the voice of Gray. Todd Haberkorn, the voice of Natsu. So, we have something that we want to start off with real quick. So, I would like for everybody to reach under your chair, and hopefully you will not find gum, but some of you will find something kind of cool taped under there. So...
Nope, that's a sticker that goes on the chair.
Nope.
So don't remove the sticker that says you cannot remove it under penalty of law.
Oh, what? She just did.
Whoops!
Mounties are coming for you.
New material.
Okay, you guys may find... what we're looking for is one of Lucy's keys. There should be a couple of Lucy's keys under your chair. There's two. There's two more? Two keys. Yes, there's two keys.
I have paws. I can't feel shit.
Yeah, two keys and three keychains.
Awesome.
Okay. Yeah, and if you have found one, you can go ahead and come up here.
No.
Alrighty, so let's see which one you've got. So it looks like this is the master keys. Yes, master keys is Pisces key. Okay, for Pisces key, we have this is a nice little collection that we've got signed by Newton and Todd, a piece of beautiful fan art here, and collection two, because episodes 25 through 48 of Fairy Tale on that. So, and then you have, she has Master Keys. Okay, Master Keys, and that is collection one, which is episodes 1 through 24, and then another lovely piece of artwork signed by guys. Okay. And then, let's see.
We have one keychain.
One keychain. Is it angry happy or happy happy? Okay. Yeah, that is an angry happy. That is not a happy happy. So angry happy is the collection five signed by the guys. And then we've got happy pass out face.
Are they not allowed to have one?
That's just your house key.
So you get the signed poster. And then you've got happy pass out face. And that is brand new collection six.
We don't even have collection six.
You'll get it next time you're in the office. So, those are hot off the presses. We just got those into the Funimation offices, so I brought a copy with me. Thank you guys very much.
Congratulations.
We hope you enjoy those.
Yeah.
So, I figured that we would just start by kind of talking about our experience, how we got introduced to Fairy Tale, and Todd and I got to do a panel similar to this at a con earlier this year, so it was really a lot of fun. So we want to make sure that we leave plenty of time for you guys to ask questions about Fairy Tale as well. But I was just going to start off real quick with my introduction to Fairy Tale was sitting at my desk at the office, and my boss walks over and goes kafunk with a stack of like 12 Fairy Tale manga, and was like, you have to read all of these and create a glossary of terms. So, because since there's, what we do at Funimation is when there's a pre-existing English translation for any show, we want to make sure that we adhere to that as closely as we possibly can, which means doing a lot of research into the manga, if there have been translated light novels and that kind of thing. We want to make sure that the terms all match up, so that's something that's really important to us. So, I got to read all of that manga and completely fall in love. So it was something that I got to follow very closely throughout the process. And then finding out that Fairy Tale would be what we would be promoting at New York Comic Con, which was my very first convention as convention manager, was really, really exciting.
Yeah, it was very exciting. I got introduced to it, the director had me in. I didn't know exactly what I was going in for. They just said that I got cast in something. So I showed up and I found out it was Fairy Tale, and Tyler, the director, started talking to me. He's like, you're going to be making, you're an ice make wizard, so you create ice things. I'm like, okay, give me more. And he's like, well, most of the time you just end up somewhere and your clothes are automatically just thrown on. And I was like, that sounds perfect for me. So my first, I guess the first con that I ever went to was in New York as well. And I think you mentioned there was about 96,000 people there one day. So I was blown away. It was pretty amazing and a gift to be able to be a part of the show. So, yeah, Todd?
You know, watching things like that AMV and being a part of something like the big premiere at a convention of that size and seeing, you know, Fairy Tale on the cover of the New York Comic Con program and signing a lot of posters for charity and stuff reminds you how special that show is, and then how to be and to being a part of it is a very unique experience. And I don't know if we'll get another one like this, because it's you know, I had no frame of reference for Fairy Tale when I came on board. I just knew that it looked like a fun show, and you know, I wanted the guy that used fire as his magic source, and I went for that. But I didn't know much about the show beyond that. And it's one of the few shows that I got a chance to do some research beforehand about it before auditioning. And so when I did go in an audition, I said this yesterday, I don't think I was what Tyler exactly wanted right off the bat. I think he was looking for something, and he, you know, some directors get a very specific idea in their head about what they want. And I don't think I was that at first. But I think once I came in and we had our first session, it fell into place. There's a lot of things that go into making casting decisions, especially on a long form show like this. So you have to really scrutinize your cast, especially the people that are going to be there every episode. And so I feel for him, because I know he's having to make this tough decision, but I'm glad he did. I'm glad he contacted me. He always calls me when it's time for a lead role. So I remember in all the places where I was at when he called me. So for this role, I was in a pizzeria in Austin, Texas, when I got the call at night, and he told me that I was going to be Natsu. And so to be a part of the show has been a wonderful experience, and it's something that it becomes a part of your life, because I record on this show every month like we do, like you do. And it's good to have panels like this and to see AMVs and to go to premieres and things like that to kind of remind us that, wow, no, we're really a part of something really, really special in this show and all over the world. I've been all over the world with this show. And people love this show from hemisphere to hemisphere. I mean, there's something about this show. And I'm just I feel so honored to be a part of it, and I hope I'm doing it justice. So, yeah. Thank you.
Awesome. I'm going to start with just kind of a basic question as well. If you were not your current character in Fairy Tale, who do you think you would have fun playing?
This is going to sound funny. I don't know. Narrating. I would love to narrate.
Magruder?
Yeah. I would love to be the... Yeah. Last week on Fairy, that's actually, that was the one that I auditioned for. That's the role that I wanted. And I told Tyler, I was like, man, this, and I didn't have the quality. The guy that does it is just amazing, but I didn't have the same quality. I was like, narrator, man, narrator. I'll help you move this weekend, narrator.
Yeah, the guy that does it is this old man named Bob Magruder. He's a little tiny, slight man. And he's kind of like Makarov. And he walks in, and he puts one headphone on, he leaves one off, and he's like, there's a little town and a little place over the hills and with the Forger's coffee man. Like, he's everything he says is so awesome. Even when he's mad at you, he's like, I'm really upset with you right now. Like, you love everything he says. And that's when I was at the premiere. I don't know if it was for you guys, but when he first came on and we heard his voice over the huge audio.
Yeah, there were about 1,500 people in that room.
Oh, it was awesome. It was like, oh, man. And the creator, Mashima-san, he was there watching it with us. That was special, too, because we got to meet with him in a special, you know, in a private room and interview with him and get him to sign stuff and take pictures with him. It was a lot of fun. That fun. I would play I would either want to be Gajil or Plu. Plu is like my, I've seen one Plu cosplay and it was kind of inappropriate, but it was fun.
Do you guys prefer when you're doing a role, like, for example, I was heavily exposed to the manga before I had seen any of the actual series itself. Do you guys prefer to go into a role cold without having really done much research into it and trust for Tyler to guide you or your director in general? Or did you guys do any research for your characters?
For me, yeah. For me, I like to go in cold, because most of the time, you guys are quick. Most of the time when you go in, it's kind of a cold reading anyway. We don't ever get the scripts beforehand, so going in there and trusting within what the director, you know, I fully trust that Tyler's going to guide me in the direction that I need to go. And when I don't go in that direction, he certainly lets me know. So I didn't do much research on it, but yeah, I like it cold.
This is a different medium, voiceover, than stage or film. And with stage and film, and Newton and I both come from the stage, we get weeks of preparation and rehearsing. So you can really build a character and build an arc of the character and that character's journey. And with film, you get some time with the script, because it's a lot of sitting around and waiting for the shots to get set up and table reads before that. And this is the one medium where we don't really get that opportunity. So any kind of research that we can do is difficult. I prefer knowing a lot of stuff about the character beforehand so that I can make informed decisions when I'm going through it. But I'm used to going in just cold, and that's why we really rely on the director. That's why we really rely on a Tyler to tell us exactly what we need to know and help us get through it. Because Tyler has written some of the episodes, he's directed the whole thing, he cast the whole thing, he line produced it. I mean, he knows everything about this show, so it's really kind of cool to be able to sit back and just rely on Tyler to guide us and really be our captain on this type of thing, you know? And so I like being told everything that's going to happen. I don't like being surprised and being told, okay, well, I'm going to tell you what happens up to episode 10 because I want you to discover it in episode 11. I don't like that, because for me, I'm going to play it a different way than I would if I knew everything. So if I go through the first 10 episodes and then Happy dies in 11, you know, I want to know that.
Saddest thing ever.
Yeah. I want to know that before I go into it so that I can kind of prep for that, not in anticipation, but it's not my job to be surprised with you guys. You guys, that's the audience's job, is to be in the experience, not mine. Mine is to live it and make it seem like it's the first time. So I prefer knowing everything going into it.
Mine is because of luck, and it's just a superstitious thing, is anything that I've ever done research for previous to never got cast. Everything that I never do research for, that's when I get cast. So now it's part of like how I have to, I like it to be cold. I want it to be, I hate to keep using that.
Raw. No, everyone.
Raw.
Chill.
Did you watch a lot of Batman and Robin?
Of course. Of course.
They call me Mr. Freeze.
What? A lot of skit in line. A lot of people hate me. No.
What do you think is the best aspect of your character's personality, and what do you think is their worst?
I think with Natsu, the best and worst quality is that the drive, the never giving up, because I feel like Natsu, that's what makes him so fierce and such a combatant as, you know, as a hero. But that also is what gets him into trouble, because he'll do things without thinking, or he'll do things without wondering, you know, well, how is this going to affect this or this or this or this, or oh, I accidentally, you know, killed this monster when this monster is actually what kept this bigger monster from coming at us and things like that. So his greatest strength is also his greatest weakness, It's kind of like my affinity for dark chocolate. It's one of my great loves, but it's also an enemy.
I think with Gray, what sticks with me is he tends to have, he's always just a little bit slightly irritated. But he seems like he has a bit of a chip on his shoulder, which works for him, I think, in the heat of the moment. But at the same time, I think that it also, it holds him back a little bit as far as his personal growth goes. But I really go towards that because I think that it's, I don't know, it's something I can relate to with that character, what I really bond to and helps me try to figure out the different, when we're working on different arcs and stuff, something I can always go back and rely on is that, I don't know, that history with him, so.
Does that quality chill you to the bone?
Very much.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a theme for the panel.
Are you?
I should have written these down.
Oh no! I thought you were thinking you're percolating. Percolating.
So, is there anything in particular that you guys would like to talk about your characters?
I mean, I want to know your Gray's workout regimen because it's pretty spicy.
What do you mean? What, like
pretty fit, Gray's.
Gray, or are you talking about Newton Pittman?
Well, I mean, I understand that it's a healthy regimen of fighting gorillas and strangling tigers with your bare hands, right?
Yes, yes. Small animals, though.
Small, yeah. Stuffed animals.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, so.
I mean, with this show, I mean, I'm always curious, because you never know how people are going to receive a show. You never know what people are going to think about. Like, I thought, when we did Sergeant Frog, man, I thought that was going to be the biggest show in the world, and everyone's going to love it, everyone's going to watch it. We're going to do 335 million episodes of that show, and we only did 82. So, like, with that show, like, with a show like Fairy Tale, what is it for you guys that makes it awesome for you? Well, does anyone have, can you put it into words? Anybody? So coming from a big family, you like how all the characters relate to each other and interact and things like that. Cool. Very cool. Yes, ma'am. So you like, she likes it because you get to understand the characters through a lot of backstory and explanation into their lives.
Well, and I think one of the really cool things about that aspect as well is the fact that it's paced so beautifully throughout the series, where it's always just like, it's like this new little door that they unlock that gives you this insight into the characters and the way that they interact with one another. So I think that's one of the really cool aspects too.
Keep going. I'm going to go to them with the microphone. Okay, so, oh, you were right over here. Hi. What's your name?
Taylor.
Taylor, why do you like Fairy Tale?
Well, I think it was one of the main parts I was attracted to is because of the guild. I mean, the characters in the show have issues with each other. They fight all the time. They say they hate each other, but they still always consider each other family no matter what happens.
Okay, very cool. So at first I thought you said because of the show has gills. That is kind of cool. Gills should be appreciated. What about you? What's your name?
Brian.
Brian, why do you like Fairy Tale?
Just expanding on her thoughts, it's like when first time watching Fairy Tale, it's like when you mess with one of them, you mess with the whole family. They'll have your back and then actually back you up through whatever problem that you have. They'll be there for you.
Yeah, because sometimes you know I've had to get in some scraps myself, and my boys said they had my back. Well, about 15 minutes before it was time to go down, you get that phone call, like, man, listen.
Yeah, it's really cool when, like, okay, one of them is down, and then all of a sudden, like, all of them just like, pop up out of nowhere, and then, like, boom, they're there. Then you have to, like, ready for a battle. the whole
thing.
Yeah,
they pop up out of nowhere like Chuck Norris in Expendables 2. He just comes out of nowhere.
Exactly, yeah.
Chuck?
He is Chuck Norris.
Yeah, it's true. Yeah, he does it twice in that movie. Let's see, who else you got? Oh, I gotta go to the Thundercats. Kind of calling it Thundercats! Oh! What's your name?
Megan.
Why do you love fairy tale? Sorry, my butt's in your...
I like the mix. I mean, you have a lot of comedy, and then you also have your moments where you're sitting there crying for the characters, and then also you have that, oh, look, more action and action on top of action.
It's like watching an episode of Oprah in just a series.
Better than Oprah.
Okay, there's a lot of action on Oprah. I mean, you see when she gives away those cars, she's like, this lemon! You know, she does things like that. It's pretty cool. Well, thank you very much. I'm glad you like fairy tale. Oh, honey senpai. Hi, okay.
How about you?
Oh. All right, yay. So, do you have another question?
Well, one of the other things I wanted to bring up was a really cool conversation I had with the brand manager, Gia Manry, back at the office, where we were talking about, I think one of the reasons why fairy tale appeals on such a kind of like sort of just broad spectrum to people also, is that we haven't seen a show this much about camaraderie and about, you know, working together, sticking together. I mean, that since a show like Sailor Moon, where you have this very defined team and they're very protective of each other, and that doesn't mean that they always get along, but it's just, it is, they have such a wonderful, unique relationship. It does remind me very much of siblings. With two older brothers, I understand Lucy's frustration. I think that you know, the fact that at the end of the day, you know, you're going to choose to love the people that you love, and you're going to choose to protect them, and I think that's a really, really cool thing.
Yeah, that's right. Who else has some fairy tale goodness here? What's your name?
My name is Brody. I actually have a question for you. Do you drive to work or?
Or with Happy? Happy flying me to work? It depends on how I'm feeling. Sometimes I'll take the tumbler, and if the tumbler is out of fuel, because it's expensive to fuel that thing up, I mean, it's got six wheels. Sometimes I'll take the Enterprise, it just depends. It's good. Happy, I don't like to. That's a lot of stunt work in that show. Happy really doesn't like to carry me that much. But thank you, Brody. Let's see. Oh my goodness. Hello. What's your name?
My name is Mackenzie.
Hi, Mackenzie. Oh, hey, thank you very much. Is it poison? Am I going to die right now? Oh, okay, thank you. Thank you for not poisoning me and a flower. It's two gifts. Why do you love fairy tale?
Well, lots of reasons. Just generally creative. And it's like core. It's a monster of the week, but it takes like yellow magi and actually does something different. Also, I have a question for you. Why does Vic follow you around? You two seem to be a lot of animes together. Are you two like besties?
Thank you for your comments. All right, let's see. Who else has something to say for fairy tale? Why does Vic follow you around?
I don't know.
I follow him. I'm riding his coattails. Let's see. Okay, I'm gonna get cozy. Hi, Mom. Is this her first convention?
Yes.
Is this your first convention?
Yes.
What do you think so far?
Awesome.
Do you want that boat outside?
Sure.
It's pretty hard to drive. You sure?
Why not?
Okay. Well, thank you for being here. So I'm gonna get it in everybody's personal space. Hi, Dad. Okay. How are you? Did you have a comment? Oh, hey, howdy, what's your name?
Brian.
Brian, that's a cool, what is it, the Nano, yeah, it's very nice, very cool. What's your comment?
I like Fairy Tail because the creativity of it, going back to that, it's not like, Natsu doesn't just shoot fire out of his hands, it's fire dragon magic, and Gray doesn't just freeze things, he, like, creates, like, yeah, exactly, it's like ice make magic, not just ice.
What's your favorite, Gray attack?
That's tough. Oh,
I thought you were about to do it. You're like... What's your top favorite? If you're like, man, my gun's out of bullets, my knife is blunt, I've got to rely on some ice magic, which one would you use?
I'm not sure.
So many.
There are some really cool ones.
Have you,
like
guys, have you guys seen the guy that's walking around as Gray with the ice cannon? Today, yeah.
No.
That, yeah, yeah. Yeah. That man is doing a public service by not wearing a shirt.
Look out for him. Thanks for your comments. Okay. Hi. Oh, hello. Hi. What's your name?
Christian.
Hi, Christian. What's your comment?
I like Gray without his shirt. I think it's funny.
I don't know if funny is what he's going for. How do you like to hear that? You're like, oh man, Gray doesn't have a shirt on, and your first reaction is to laugh, not to be like, ooh. Very cool. Well, thank you. Thank you for watching. You have another question for us, Sully? Or?
I was just going to make a comment as far as one of my favorite things that doesn't really communicate in the manga quite as well is when it'll pop from one scene where Gray is sitting there and he's got clothes on, and then it pops back to him and he's just wearing boxers, and it was just, and then Urza always winds up coming in and just like, put some clothes on! I really like the level of leadership that they get from Urza, where at first she's just like, oh, this is stupid, I don't want to do this, but then as she gets to know them and gets to know their stories and everything like that, there's a much deeper level of understanding that builds throughout the series. I think that's really, really cool.
Do you guys, now I don't know, you know, I haven't seen all the episodes, does Natsu wind up with Lucy, or what's the deal?
Spoilers! Depends on the fanfiction you read.
Ah. But no Urza, there's no like, Natsu Urza going on. Right?
No, she's
okay.
Saying it.
There's a better someone for Urza?
Lol.
Oh, Urza gets with Happy?
Jalal.
Okay. Oh, Jalal. Okay. Yes, that's cool. I guess that's all right. Darn it, Urza was cool.
Then hey, Todd, do we want to do that special surprise that we brought for them?
Oh, yeah. Do you guys want a surprise?
Yeah!
Okay.
Now, how many people are allergic to peanuts, though? Because if you have a peanut allergy, I don't know if you're going
to
like
it. It has nothing
surprise.
To do with peanuts. Okay, so how many of you are super stoked about the fairy tale movie? Woo! How many of you want to see the first 20 minutes of it with the dub? All right, that's exactly what we're going to do right now. Literally, I got this disc right before I left Funimation, so we're not quite ready to do the premiere yet, but we wanted to make sure that you guys would be able to see that. We're actually going to go down front, because these guys have not seen any of this either. This literally just finished getting mixed, so this is the first time this is being seen publicly.
Sorry, babe.